Hello friends, what's up? Thank you so much for watching Circuits Bazaar. So today we are going to study the project Advanced Prepaid Energy Meter with automatic under and over voltage cut. So in this project we are going to use a lot of things. So one by one I am going to explain each and every point of this project. So this is the high current adapter. This is 2 ampere adapter. You cannot drive this project with 1 ampere adapter. That's why I have used 2 ampere, because there is loads of power consumption in this project. This section is also running on 12 volt, and then GSM modem which require proper current. If you are not providing proper current, then it won't work at all, right? So that's why we have used 12 volt adapter. Now, this is the mobile number I have given in the programming. So all the messages I will get on this number, so you can change any number whatever you want. And the circuit diagram or code regarding this project is given in the description below. If you have any doubt, you can ask me the question in the comment box. Now, this is the GSM modem, which is GSM 900, right? So over here you have to insert the SIM. So this is the SIM I have inserted over here, right? This is the GSM antenna, and these are the three wires. One is transmitter wire, another is receiver wire, another is ground. And this is the 12 volt power supply of this GSM 900 modem. So the power supply is coming from this board, right? Not this board, like power supply from GSM modem, because I will apply the this DC jack on this connector, DC connector. So power will go to this board as well, from here this board, and it means every section of the project will get power from this jack, right? Now if I talk about there are two LCD. One LCD will display the status of the energy meter and the recharge amount, all those type of things. And this is the another LCD which I have used for the voltage of the house, like whether voltage is under or over or medium voltage. So whatever the voltage is, you can see on this LCD, and whatever is the status of your money will be shown on this LCD. So why I have used two microcontroller, one is this one, one is this one, because this microcontroller is reading pulse from the energy meter. So at the same time, if I'll use the same microcontroller to monitor the voltage as well, then it creates problem. That's why I have used individual microcontroller, one for the meter reading, another for the AC line voltage reading, right? Now if I talk about this circuit, this is if you don't have 12 volt DC power, then you can also use 12 volt transformer as well. That's why I have used bridge rectifier over here. These two capacitors acting as a filter circuit over here. This is 7805 voltage regulator, because of our microcontroller LCD indicators all are working on 5 volt. That's why I have used 7805 voltage regulator. And this aluminum part is called heat sink, which will absorb the heat generated by the 7805 voltage regulator. And this is the reset button. If there is any malfunction, you can press this button as well. And this is the LCD which will show you the money present and the unit you have to consume, right? And the microcontroller is ATmega328. The programming of this ATmega328 microcontroller is done in the Arduino environment. And this is potentiometer. This potentiometer will set the contrast of the LCD. This is pull-up resistor to boost up the signal. And these are the audio visual indicator which we can utilize to show some type of indications in the project, like low balancer, all those type of things. You can also show visually and with this buzzer, audio instruction you can also provide to the user, right? This is the power LED. This LED will on and off whenever the project will get the power. So this is all about this section. Now if I come to this section, this section of this PCB is same with this section, right? Same like rectifier, filter, 7805 voltage regulator, indicator. Over here we have red indicator, over here we have green indicator, and the same microcontroller at Mega328, and this will show the voltage present in the house. And to vary the voltage, I have used this dimmer circuit. So this is the dimmer which will vary the voltage of your house. Okay, so this is the voltage. This voltage 230 volt AC you will fit to the meter. This is coming 230 volt AC into your meter, and from here we are also monitoring, like what is the incoming voltage, right? You can see that this is incoming voltage, and from here the voltage we are giving to the dimmer as well, so that we can monitor this voltage. Because if you are showing this project to someone, so you need to have some variable source of AC provider. So that's why I have used dimmer. So this voltage is then fed to this 6 volt transformer. This 6 volt transformer We'll get 230 volt AC or 1010 volt AC, whatever the dimmer will provide to it, and it will be fed to this voltage divider and rectification circuit. Then this will fed to the this section. Like over here we are getting 6 volt, then it will be further divided as well through this voltage divider configuration, because this microcontroller cannot get voltage above 5 volt. You know that microcontroller is working on 5 volt. That's why you have to divide this voltage. And this single diode we are using for the rectification purpose. The voltage, whatever the voltage, 6 volt or 5 volt or 3 volt will come out, this is AC, so you need a rectifier. That's why I have used this half wave rectifier and capacitor to make the constant voltage, right? Then that is fed to this microcontroller. This microcontroller will read, and we have done programming how to read the voltage, right? The code is given in the description, you can download, and that will be shown on the LCD. So if voltage is above 100, below 100 volt, that will be under voltage, and if voltage will be above 240 volt, that will be over voltage, and in between a normal condition. So whenever the voltage will be below 100, then this microcontroller will provide signal to this microcontroller, and this microcontroller will give signal to GSM modem to send the message to the owner of the house, like unsafe voltage is detected. And whenever the voltage will be above 240, then this will send give message on the LCD over voltage, and also at the same time will pass signal to this microcontroller. This microcontroller will then give message to the GSM modem, and GSM modem will send message to the owner, unsafe voltage detected. And this is the reset button. This reset button is for this unit, and this reset button is for this unit, right? Now if I talk about this unit, this is relay section. This is connected to this board. You know that you cannot drive relay directly using microcontroller. You have to use transistor as amplifier. So I have used two transistor BC547 over here, which will amplify the current coming from this microcontroller and will drive this relay. And this relay will further drive the load. So this relay is basically controlling the output of the house. Okay. So if you don't have money in your wallet, then this relay will cut down your supply. So this load is representing as your output of your house supply from the meter. So you won't be able to use the output if you don't have proper balance in your wallet, right? Now this LED indicator is for relay whether on or off. If relay is on, then this LED is on. If relay is off, then this LED is off. And this is the diode. You know that any device which have coils, when this device get frequently on and off, that's why you have to use back EMF bypasser, which is this diode over here, which will bypass the back EMF. And this capacitor is for the smooth on off of the relay, right? The circuit diagram of this Darlington pair as well is given in the description given below. Now come to this section. This is optocoupler 4N35. So the voltage, these are the two wire which is taking voltage from this meter, and this voltage is fed to this optocoupler, and then again this optocoupler is generating signal for the microcontroller. So these yellow and green wire is going to the microcontroller, like you can see that these yellow and green wire going to the microcontroller. So it will generate pulse according to the load. If load is very heavy, then fast pulse will be generated. If load is normal, then normal pulse will be generated, right? So this is all about basic idea of this project. Now I'm going to show you the live working of this project. And manually, if you want to on and off the load, then you can use this button. Load is off, load is on, right? Now, this is the adapter which I'm going to provide the power supply. So this is 230 volt of which will go to the meter and house as well. Okay, now I'm going to the all the messages I will get on my this mobile number. Now I'm going to provide the power supply through this DC jack. You can use bigger bulb as well, right? Now, message finding module, and this is the communication LED. If this LED will start blinking slowly, it means you got the signal. Otherwise, there is no signal. Now, first of all, I'm going to off the load because I want to show you. So a message I got is system ready. This is the message I got. System ready is the message I got right now. Okay. Now, the balance already in your system is balance 75 rupees, and units you have 15 unit you have, and balance is 75. Okay. So one by one I am going to explain each and every feature of the project. So if you will own the load, you can see the reading will start decreasing over here. Right now balance is 70 rupees. So if you will on the load, so I'm going to on the load. Now you can see that over here. Now 65 rupees balance, okay. After some time the balance will be 60 because this load is consuming the power, right? Now you can see that load become 60. So if you will off the load, then you can see that there will be no change on the readings over here, right? Now this is the voltage, line voltage. So this is the button, potentiometer you can say, through which you can change the voltage of the line like this. Now voltage is increasing, 140, 150, okay. And whenever the voltage will be above 240, then you can see over voltage will be the message over here, right? आप चलते रहेंगे। चलते रहेंगे। Now you can see that voltage is so whenever you will increase the voltage, then over voltage will come and message, I will get the message. Under voltage, okay. I must guess, and this GSM modem sent the message. I must guess message on my mobile phone. This is the message which I got on my mobile phone, unsafe voltage. Okay, this is the message, unsafe voltage detected. Now if I'll increase the voltage, then the again message I will get on my mobile number will be unsafe message, but over here the voltage, the message will be over voltage. Message is sent and I must get unsafe message, right? If you'll make the voltage normal, this is the message, unsafe voltage detected. So this is the message on my mobile, unsafe message again I got because voltage was over. So if voltage is below 100, even then I will get the message. If voltage will be above 240, even then I will get the message. And if voltage is in between the range of 100 and 240, then I won't get any message. And this is also shown on here what voltage is, and you can vary the voltage through this potentiometer. Now you can see that voltage is nearly 158 159, but if you want to increase, you have to rotate in this direction, voltage become over. If you want to decrease the voltage, then you can rotate in this direction, okay, as simple as that. Now voltage is 129 degree 129. If you want to decrease the voltage, then you will see after 100 I will get the message, I am decreasing the voltage. Under voltage message on the LCD, and over here message sent. I will again keep it normal. This is the message, unsafe voltage, right? Unsafe voltage is the message I got, okay. Now I am going to on the load. So this is the load. Now you can see that reading is will start decreasing. 11 is the unit we have and 55 is the balance. Now balance become 50, okay. So whenever the balance will be less than 15, then I will get the message, low balance. And if the voltage will be below 5, then sorry. Now you can see that balance is decreasing. Whenever the balance will be below 15, then the relay will cut. See, this relay is on, that's why this LED is on. Whenever the balance will be below 5, then immediately I will get the message, power supply of your house is cut down, right? Now balance is decreasing because load is on. So unit becomes 6, then balance is 30. It's decreasing. You can also recharge as well if you want by pressing, by dialing hash. First of all, I'm going to show you the feature which is going on. Okay, now balance become 20. Whenever the balance will be below 15, then I will get the message low balance. Low balance, and I must get a message on my mobile. Message received. So we are going to recharge hash 50 a star. I will send here, and I will send. It will get the message, and the meter will be recharged with 50. So this is the amount, and you can see relay will be on after some time now, because you have balance. 10 was earlier balance, and now you can see balance start decreasing, and the message immediately you will get on your mobile is energy meter balance. Your meter has been recharged with amount 50 rupees. Now you can see on the LCD reading is decreasing, right? Load is on because you have balance more than 15. So whenever you will get the balance below 15, then you will immediately get message on your mobile number, and after 5 balance, then your voltage of your or supply of your house will be cut down, right? And this is the relay which will do that function. Now balance is decreasing over here, right? You can off the load as well from here if you want, right? Then you will see over here, like you can see now, there is the reading over here will be constant. Whenever I on the load, then immediately reading will start decreasing, right? Now 25 20, low balance, right? Message sent. This is the message I got. Energy meter balance low, right? Energy meter balance low, okay? And power supply cut down because of low balance. And I will again get the message, your house power supply is cut down because of low balance. This is the message I got. The message I got is energy meter alert, light cut due to low balance, please recharge your energy meter, thank you. And now to recharge the balance on this SIM, I need to send a message. The message is has whatever the amount I want to recharge, has 50 a star, has 50 star. Has is the prefix and star is the suffix, and in between you can write down any amount you want to recharge. So send the message. This will receive the message. Message is received and a recharge, and you can see load will be on. Why? Because recharge is successful.